Let's go. Hey everybody, I'm back, and this is the final. I'm laughing because I'm saying this is the final part of my audio CD video collection, but I think I said that before and it wasn't. But I think it is this time, so let's go. The next one is... you guys will be a little bit surprised at this one. Now, this is a soundtrack that I bought really as a completion to a set of films that I already had. Now, let me say that I used to have the soundtrack to Alien on cassette tape. I don't know what happened to it. Then I, of course, had Aliens on cassette tape. Don't know what happened to it. And then I finally got Alien 3. And for the most part, I don't really care about the soundtrack. I don't really like the music. I like the opening song and the ending song, and that's it. And to be honest, I don't even know if I've watched or listened to the entire CD. But this is how the inside of it looks. Pretty good shot of Ripley there. And the actual CD. I don't. What's on the book, I wonder? Let's see. Well, it's in color. Oh, there we go. It's a collection of the skinheads there. And but Ripley's nice. Hey, is she crying in that picture? She is crying in that picture. Can you see that? My girl's crying. But then again, if I was in Alien 3, I'd fucking cry too. But anyway, let's put this back. This way. Let's try to get this finished. I only got 6 more soundtracks. Whoa, get that out of the way. Now, you guys are going to kill me for owning this one, but I got to tell you, you know, I'm not really a huge fan of James Horner, but, you know, I give credit where credit's due. And I know a lot of you guys really harp on the soundtrack that James Horner did for Aliens, and I think it's just an okay soundtrack because a lot of the music used in it is lifted right from his other movies. And I just, composers that use music from other movies, that gets on my nerves. And James Horner is really guilty of doing that. But this is Titanic, which is, and I even got to say, even in this soundtrack, Horner lifted some music from Aliens and Star Trek 2. But overall, really beautiful music. I like the kind of Irish-sounding music that he uses in here. There's a picture of the CD itself. Pretty nice. Picture of the Titanic. I've seen this movie one time, and... I thought it was a very well-made film. Leonardo DiCaprio and is it Kate Winslet, I think. But they're really likable characters, and the film's decent. But I have no desire to watch it again. This is really a long insert here. If I can get it all on there, yeah, there we go. Yeah. There we go. I know you can't see any of that, but it's a decent film, but I have no desire to watch it. I really don't want to own it. I won't buy it. And not because I don't like the film. It's just, and once is enough. And if I owned it, I'd never watch it again. Now, here's two that I have the actual motion picture score, and then I have the music from and inspired by the motion picture, which is, one, you know how movies today kind of go crazy on the fucking songs that they put in movies instead of instrumentals? Well, one of them is an instrumental of the music, and the other one is the actual score of the film. And it's Space Jam. And I like some of the music in Space Jam. I thought it was pretty nice. Now, this is the actual, the one with the singing in it. And then I have the actual soundtrack of Space Jam, which is also nice. There's both of them together. And I think they're both the same inside too. There's the this is the singing one with the rap songs and everything. And then we have this one, yeah, different color CD but the same picture basically. What's in the book, I wonder? I mean, I know it's pictures and all, but of what? I have never looked in this book. There we go. Space Jam. I kind of like Space Jam. It's kind of a lightweight movie. Not a whole lot to it, but, you know, I'm such a huge fan of the Looney Tunes that I liked it. I even liked that one with Brendan Fraser and Bugs Bunny and Daffy and all those characters, even though that was not even as good as Space Jam. Come on, get in here. Now, will you go in there? I hate when they won't slide in the damn thing like they're supposed to. Hell in there. Okay. I can go over these pretty quickly because they're all related to the same subject here. Now, this is the Monster movie music album, which is composers, different composers scoring classic monster themes like Godzilla, King Kong, Mysterious Island, and 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. But it's decent renditions of the classic monster themes. And that's what I like about it, because it's really nice. And it's nice to have a different composer take on a take of these movies. There's the CD itself. And I got this quite a long time ago. I think it's an officially licensed CD, but yeah. I was just going to say that. They go over the songs a little bit. They don't use any pictures from the films. They probably wasn't allowed to. But that's it for that. Good music, though. I used one of the themes, the theme to King Kong. And here's a secret, guys. When you want to use a theme that's really copyrighted and everything, like the Star Wars theme or the Godzilla theme or whatever theme that's really well known and you can't use it, if you can get a different version of it, like this here, you can use it. They won't stop you. Now, I used to have two of these, the best of the Godzilla films, 1954 to 1975. There was one that came after this, and it has to be around here somewhere, but I don't know where it is, but I had both of these. This is actual, is this Crescendo? Yeah, this is Crescendo, and this label, they always do music. They lift the music from the actual film score, and it sounds kind of sucky sometimes because it's not the best recordings to do it that way. I would much prefer that they just get a composer to score the damn music. But this is music from the early films, 1954 to 1975, the films that were produced at that time. I mean, it's really nice to have these. The booklet is really nice, and talks a little bit about Akira Ifukube, who composes most of this music. So, I mean, it's a nice thing to have. And I'm proud to have it. You know, this is pretty damn rare to get Godzilla music in the States. And finally, guys, this is another one of those albums that is licensed music by different composers. It's called Monster Mania. And music from the classic Godzilla films, 1954 to 1995. Has several tunes on it. Godzilla King of the Monsters, Destroy All Monsters. In all, it has 22 songs, and it's composed here in America. All new digital recordings, not from original soundtracks. And it's really nice. And let's see, I wonder if... There's a CD there, Monster Mania. I wonder if they use actual pictures in here from the films. I kind of doubt it. And no, they didn't. I didn't use any actual pictures. Couldn't get away with it. But there you have it, guys. That's my audio CD collection. I have more. That's pretty nice. I don't know where they are. But when I find them after going through all my stuff, I will definitely do an addendum to this and show you guys. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you at the next collectible set of videos, which I think the next one is going to be me focusing on some of my magazine collection. I think I have quite a bit of Mad magazines and the original Star Trek magazines, and I'm thinking about selling them on eBay. But thanks for watching, guys. Take care, and I'll see you all later on. Bye-bye.